two squat variations that will help you build some strength in your legs. The previous video looked at the potato sack squat and the goblet squat, which are useful for patterning, okay, for building your squat movement pattern. Once that movement pattern is natural and ingrained, you can then start to look at loading up the body. This is where these two varieties come into play nicely. You've got the single kettlebell front rack squat and the double kettlebell front rack squat. Both of these, because of how the kettlebell is held, allow you to load the legs a lot more. So it's got a greater potential for strength, these two movements. Your front rack squat begins with that rack position, as the name suggests, okay? So this needs to be solid. When you're learning the single kettlebell variation, highly recommend that you practice this position. You get the kettlebell into place, you walk around, you make sure that this position here, holding the kettlebell on the arm, feels natural and feels solid, okay? If the weight feels heavy here or it feels like it's not in the right position, you're gonna have a hard time loading this movement heavy. So don't forget, the front rack squat variations, both the single and the double, start with that rack position. And it may be that you need to spend some time getting comfortable here first. So, here's what you're gonna do. Kettlebell is gonna start on the ground. You're gonna begin behind the kettlebell. Grab it, okay? I'm gonna clean the kettlebell with this hand. I'm gonna use this hand to support me. So I'm gonna wrap my free arm or free hand around that working hand. Now from here, I'm literally just gonna throw the kettlebell through my legs and guide it into the wrap position. Okay, so when I get to the top here, I'm gonna make sure it's comfortable. I'm gonna make sure the weight is not sitting on the forearm. I'm gonna make sure it's sitting in the crook of the arm. Okay, so basically in the space between your forearm and your bicep. That's where you want the kettlebell to be sitting. I wanna have a straight wrist. Forearm should be vertical here. Nice little tip on this one is to just pull that elbow down to the hip. And you should feel the muscles in the back start to fire up. From here, I'm gonna find my squat stance. Get everything tight, squeeze the kettlebell hard if you need to. You can hold one hand here, then release before the squat. If you're struggling, keep that hand there. When you're ready, put it down, two hands, guide it to the floor. So that's really all there is to it. Highly recommend, like I said, that you get comfortable in that rack position. So take your time. Don't just throw the kettlebell up here and get squatting. Take your time. Make sure that the kettlebell is sitting here between the bicep and the forearm. Contrary to popular belief, the kettlebell does not sit on the forearm. It sits here, okay? Obviously, unless you've got a tiny kettlebell, a miniature kettlebell, it's gonna touch these two parts of your arms. What I mean by this is that the main bulk of the weight is sitting in this spot here. The pressure of the weight is here. Okay, so make sure you get that right first before you commence squatting, okay? Now, once you've got a good feel for this movement, and you feel tight, you feel connected when you do this, you can introduce a second kettlebell. Now, with this one, you can do either matching kettlebells or misloaded kettlebells. Now, myself, like most people, don't have two of every single kettlebell. So I'm going to demonstrate this movement with misloaded weights. That seems like it would be less than optimal. When you try this, you'll find that actually it's a hell of a lot trickier than doing it with perfectly balanced weights, as your body will need to not only stop yourself from getting pulled forward by the weights, but you also have to resist that twist, because the heavier kettlebell is going to pull you to one side. Your job is to kind of even things out. The only thing with this is when you're doing it with misloaded weights that you obviously do one set with the light kettlebell on this side or that side, and then you switch it for the next one and you alternate between the two to even it out. So, for my double front rack squat, I'm going to take my kettlebell, place them on the ground. You can either put them neutral in an arrow formation or a V formation, okay? I usually go neutral, so both handles facing forward, more or less. Kettlebells here should be touching. Now, with your double kettlebells, you want to make sure that when you swing them into position, you've got enough space, okay? You've got two weights rather than one, so some of us might need to take the legs a bit wider for the clean and then bring them in a little bit on the squat, okay? So, everything is the same, except this time we're going to have to handle each kettlebell independently, okay? So you're not going to be able to find that front rack position or support that working arm with your free arm. They're both going to be working here. So it's really important that the single kettlebell front squat is on point first. And we get behind the weight. Grab my bells, tilt them towards me, and clean. Okay? From here, I'm going to adjust my stance. Forearms vertical. Wrists are nice and straight here. The weight is in the crook of the arm, crook of the elbow. I'm going to pull the elbows down towards my hips to engage the lats. And I'm going to squat down. Inhale. Exhale up. Exhale up. That's really all there is to it. All starts with that front rack position. Remember, wrist straight, elbow, pull it towards the forearm, and keep everything nice and tight to the body. At no stage do I have a gap. I chicken wing the arm out, that's not going to be good. My delt is going to do too much here. I'm not going to let the kettlebell wrestle me this way either. Again, pull the elbow to the hip, cement it in position. Thumb, good test on this one, is to check that you're in the right position, is just to point the thumb out. It should be around about level with your collarbone. Okay, if you do this, and it pokes you in the eye, or you do this, and it doesn't touch anything, it means that your wrist or your kettlebell handle and your fists are in the wrong position. So, two good land points or landmarks to look out for here. Elbow on the hip and thumb touches the collarbone if you are to extend it towards the body. Two squat variations to enable you to start building some strength in your legs.